Westinghouse Studio One. Westinghouse, the name that means sureness. Whether it's on the finest television sets made today or jet engines for America's planes, whether it's a product for your home, for your business, for your farm, or your factory, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
Pretty serious. At her age, it might even take a couple of dabs of glue.
Won't hurt?
No.
Fix it now, Daddy.
No, no, honey. Later.
You look hot.
Inside and out. Al Huddlestone's been fooling around with our irrigation pump again, trying to cut off our water. Where does he think that'll get him? You have to have water in this country or quit and go back to the city. Tell me, Brittany, you like it up here?
I like it anywhere you are.
That isn't what I asked you.
I love it here, Jeff. Is that better?
I'm serious.
Me too.
Tell me, you don't miss the next door neighbors, the movies, the store on the corner?
No.
Yeah, I guess I knew what you'd say. And as soon as that Huddlestone gets it through his head that we're here to stay, maybe he'll quit mucking with our water. You just can't do that to a neighbor around here. Let's go.
Go?
Sure. It's Saturday night. Everybody who belongs around here goes to Cap's on Saturday night.
The store?
Sure, in this time we let people know that we did belong. Oh, you'll have fun. There's tables there, and you sit around and drink beer. Cap plays records from heaven knows where. You can dance.
I'd have to dress.
Oh, no, don't dress up. I want people around here to see what I married. And I want to eat that Al Huddlestone on neutral ground and let them know exactly where we stand.
Jeff, if you lose your temper...
Oh, I'll tell them all nice and polite, but I'm serious, Rita. Now, quit worrying.
You look like a grizzly bear.
You do, Daddy. Daddy!
Oh, let's see. Must be about 12 years since I went to Cap's on a Saturday night.
What did you used to take?
Oh, nobody in particular. Carrie, mostly.
Al Huddlestone's wife?
Yeah, only her name was Carrie Brown then.
Funny, I know you so well, and there's the things I don't know at all.
Yeah?
What you were like then, for instance?
Oh, I was a beauty. All the girls were crazy about me.
Jeff, I'm glad we're going to stick it out here. I'm glad this is going to be home for us.
Look, we'll park Carol and Mrs. Ellis down the road, huh?
Let's get started. I can... Cut it out! Don't you touch it, I can tell. Oh, I forgot. Jeff O'Clock, how are you?
How are you, Cap?
Well, it's about time you dropped in and say hello.
Well, it's regular old Saturday night, I see. Usual rush. Cap, I want you to meet my wife, Frieda. This is Cap Manning. He was there before the hill.
I'm happy to know you, Mrs. Clark.
Thank you.
I see the Huddlestones are out in full force.
Yes, indeed. As many as ever, all by themselves. Mm-hmm. Marsh Huddleston leading the parade, as usual. Hey, Jeff, how come you up and married this pretty little thing?
Why don't you ask her? Excuse me, honey.
Jeff.
Hello, Al. Hi, kid.
My name's Bubber.
Okay, I'm sorry, Bubber. How are you, Al?
Fair enough.
Look, you've been fooling around with our irrigation pump again.
Who says so?
Al, you're perfectly welcome to that water while I was away. But I'm back now. The water's mine and I need it.
Look, I'll put a little service here.
Al, I don't want any trouble. But if I have to watch that pump 24 hours a day, I'm going to do it.
Why don't you crawl away?
You heard what he said? Beat it.
Hands off or I'll bust your thick head.
Why, you...
Jeff!
Get him out! Sit down and keep your hands to yourself, Bob. You too, Al. Hello, Marsh. How are you?
All right, Jeffrey.
Look. Al's got some sort of a bee in his mind about cutting off our irrigation water.
All right, Jeffrey, just don't go looking for trouble.
Last thing I want, Marsh.
I'll talk to you.
Jeff, I asked you.
Forget it, it's all right.
Out of the stones, don't let him get you, Jeff.
Nebro, how are you, Nebro? I want you to meet my wife, Frieda.
Happy to meet you, man.
So you're Nebro.
Come on, let's sit down.
Okay.
Waiting for you.
May I sit down, please?
Yes, take mine, Carrie.
Oh, thanks,
where you been?
I'm thirsty. Somebody get me a drink.
I said, where you been?
Hello, Carrie.
Hi, Bob. Well, it's a big night. Everybody's here, huh? Everybody's happy. Look, you. You look like sour milk at a picnic. Who thinks my husband's so sweet?
That's enough out of you two. What we need around here is some drinks. Bubba, get up and get us some drinks.
Yeah, do that, Bubba, and let's calm this thing down.
Can the yelling, huh, Carrie?
Hope you two are here to settle for good.
If they'll let us.
Welcome home, Jeff.
Hello, Billy. How are you? Say, I'm counting on you to help me run cattle next week.
Like old times, Jeff. I'll be there.
Okay, Bill.
Jeff! You old...
Hello,
old
Dave. Dave Waller. Dave and I grew up together. I want you to meet my wife, Frieda, Dave.
Well, any wife of Jeff's a friend of mine. I claim a dance with the bride.
Bride? With a 7-year-old daughter. I'd love to dance.
Well, we may never see you again.
Good riddance. How do you like that, Jeff Clark? He's back here after all that time and tries to take over like he never left.
His land and his water. Right's right, Al, and the sooner you realize it, the better off you'll be.
I want to dance. You gonna sit there all night like an old woman?
For the past week now, you've been jumping down my gullet every time I open my mouth.
Well,
hey, Carrie, I'll dance with
you always look pretty when you're mad.
Yeah, and I'm always mad.
Carrie, I got to see you alone. Look, you've been avoiding me all week. What's the matter?
Carrie!
Jeff?
Hello, Carrie.
Dance, Jeff?
Yeah, sure.
Not too. Jeff, how long are you going to make me wait?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, yes, you do.
Look, Harry, it's all over between us. It's been over for 12 years. We're different people now.
Not so different as you think. Oh, Jeff, how could you make me wait so long? When I think of what I should have married and
what I married.
Jeff. Jeff, I'll be home all day tomorrow. Al will be gone. When you'll be up?
I won't be.
Oh, well, sure you will. I thought you'd be up long before now. I thought fooling with that irrigation pump would give you a good excuse.
Pump, what do you know about that?
I just heard. Oh, forget it. When you be up tomorrow?
Look, Carrie, I may have been feeding a kid up for a couple of days. Like to see the horses. Thanks for the dance.
Oh, Jeff, wait. If you run out on me now, I... All right, go on. Go on and see what it gets you. You'll be back on your knees.
Well, here she is, Jeff. Dance is like a feather.
Thanks, Dave.
What's the matter, Jeff?
Oh, nothing.
She looks so odd, sick almost.
She is sick. Honey, let's get out of here.
Shouldn't we say goodnight?
Next time. Look here, Al. You get out of here before you get some real trouble on your hands.
Everybody said, Bubber, you're a witness.
Look, kid. This must be Carrie's bright idea. He talked to Al and knew he's got you here because he's afraid to tackle me himself. Why don't you ask your brother Marsh about the land rights and the water rights around here? He'll tell you I always owned this pump and we always shared the water.
You share nothing.
Kid, if you're smart, you'll go home.
You're staying away from that pump, that's all I know.
Get around the other side of Bubber.
Now look, kid. Stay out of this and let me handle this crazy fool by myself.
Now!
Oh! Get out of carriage and wash your face. Let me see. All right, you're not hurt. But you will be if you don't stay away from here. Now get out of here. Huddlestone, his kid brother, fooling around with that irrigation pump again. He must be crazy.
Jeff, do you think if you went to see Marsh Huddleston, he could put a stop to it?
He'll stop. We had a fight about an hour ago. Al ran when I happened to hit the kid in the face with a shovel. I didn't hurt him much. He was scared mostly, that's all.
Oh, Jeff, now you've got to see Marsh before Al does. They're bound to twist your story.
Yeah, maybe you're right. Marsh is fair. Maybe we can settle this thing once and for all.
I'll go with you. What is it, dear?
Car coming. You go ahead and get dressed. I'll see who it is. Hello, Marsh. Just coming down to see you.
Yes, you were.
See, Al, he's been lying to you again, huh?
Oh,
you...
Shut up, Al.
Marsh ain't often lying to you.
We got eyes. A kid like Bubba.
I'm sorry, it was an accident. They both jumped me. I didn't mean to hit him. Maybe Al didn't tell you that. I only cut him a little right
here. Yeah. Well, where's Bubba? Why don't you ask him? He won't lie.
No, he won't lie.
Hey, what are you doing here? What's Bubba to you?
How could you do it, Jeff?
Do what? How could you go and do a thing like that?
Like what? Frida, go back in the house.
Jeff.
Frida, go back in the house. We're talking.
Jeff, what's wrong?
Frida, get back in the house.
Mommy!
I see my brother's face. You didn't need to do nothing like that.
Like what, Marsh? Like what?
Get in the car.
What for?
Listen to him. He ought to be strung up and he's asking what for.
I said get in the car. If there's a law on this land, or even if there ain't, you're gonna pay for killing him.
He's dead?
Let's get moving while we're reasonable.
Look, Marsh, I saw the kid. I couldn't have killed him. He just had a little cut right there, honestly.
We don't want to settle this right here in front of your wife and kid. Now get in that car.
I'm not going to get in any car. Now listen, I'll talk to the sheriff if you want to bring him up here. But wait a minute, there's some things you can't do. Look, you guys aren't the law around
here. Which, Colin, Jeff, you're coming with us.
Hell, a rifle, fast, Al!
Get him,
all right, Lou.
Seen part one of The Kill, let's turn to our Westinghouse program and Betty Furness. Guess what these flowers say? Well, I don't know. Flowers can say lots of nice things.
They certainly can. And these particular flowers say a lovely thank you. I just received them this evening from a Studio One fan. Here's the note that came with them. Dear Betty, it reads, this is to thank you for helping me sell my husband on a new Westinghouse frost-free refrigerator. He saw you demonstrate it the other night, and you convinced him. We bought one, and both agree it's the most helpful refrigerator ever made. Yes, lots of people agree that no other refrigerator is as helpful as the Westinghouse Frost Free. Because, well, for one thing, it eliminates all the mess and work of defrosting. It's completely automatic. You look inside some refrigerators that claim that they're automatic, and you'll find there are still things for you to do. For instance, some of them have a container like this that fills up with defrost water, and you have to empty it. I don't call that very helpful, do you? Or automatic. Now, I know you're going to want to see the genuine frost-free, so let me show you how you identify it. You see that? That's the magic button, the sign of the exclusive frost-free system. Now, you never touch that button. Every time you close the door, this knob right here pushes the button and counts the door opening. It's the warm, moist air that enters the refrigerator when the door is open that causes frost. Now, when that button has counted enough door openings for frost to have started to form on the freezer, the button automatically gives a signal that starts the frost-free system working. And every bit of frost is wiped away so quickly that the frozen foods here in your freezer always stay firmly frozen. There's absolutely nothing for you to do. So go to your Westinghouse dealer and see this and the other good-looking frost-free models. There's a size for every kitchen and a price for every purse. And remember, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
We return now to Westinghouse Studio One and The Kill.
Before. Bubba's head was busted. Mashed. I saw it. Al saw it. Link here saw it. You wouldn't have known Bubba. A mad dog got to him. Jeff Flock with a shovel. You hear that? A shovel. Now we're going to get him. We're going to hunt him down night and day until we find him. Then we're going to nail him to a tree. And I'll envy the man who catches Jeff Flock in his sights for the rest of my life. And we'll get him. There's maybe 100 men out already.
We'll put a ring around these mountains so he can't get out. He's penned in the valley here somewhere. Now let's move in for the kill.
Come on, Marsh, we're ready.
Talk won't get him.
Yeah, let's get him, Marsh.
Hogan's got a gun on him.
He's got nothing, but neither is the wounded elk. Remember, he's a crazy, mad killer. We want him dead on this. That's all I got to say.
That's good. Come on, let's go.
Come on.
I'm killing me a mad dog.
Not if I see him first.
Joe and him was buddies, Negro. You still buddies?
Comes a killing like this, nobody's nobody's buddy.
Close the door behind me. How'd it happen, Jeffrey?
I don't know.
I can't piece it together, Cap. I swear I didn't hit him that hard.
Always that away in a fight.
Look, what were they doing here?
Putting together a manhunt. Every able-bodied man in the county will be after you.
You're crazy, Cap. Just a Huddlestone, you mean?
No. Everybody.
I don't believe it. I know everybody in this country.
You don't know anybody. You don't even know me. A thing like this gets the men all riled up. You run and they all come howling after you, each one of them panting to be in on the kill.
You wouldn't try to scare me, would you, Cap?
Yes, I would, if it would make you realize what you're up against.
You? You be in on the hunt?
Too old. 20 years ago, maybe. This is just like tracking a big buck, only 100 times more exciting. And those men haven't had as much fun in years. I remember I was always sorry after I killed a deer, but it didn't stop me from hunting. Now you remember, he wants you dead only, and nothing or nobody's going to stop them from delivering.
Cap, this is just between me and the Huddlestone.
You keep right on thinking that way and you get yourself shot, son, or worse. I saw them here tonight. Negro will be hunting you. Dave Walters, all of them.
Dave was up there this afternoon. Cap, I can't figure it. The fight here with Al, the battle with Kerry, the fight with the kid at the pump house. I can't piece it together. But I'm sure Kerry egged them on.
Kerry might. But that doesn't make any difference now. Jeffrey, you've got to get yourself out of this area.
It can't be that serious, Cap.
I wish I could keep you here, boy. But I'm a little too old for that now. Hold up somewhere, Jeffrey. Stay calm. Keep quiet. This thing sort of calms down. It'll take time, but they'll get tired. In the meantime, I'll tell Freedy okay. And here. Sandwiches. You'll need them. Jeff. Take this along. I don't use it no more.
Thanks, Cap. Thanks a lot.
Remember, you got to hurry now, son. They've got all the roads and bridges blocked. Don't underestimate no one. Be careful, Jeffrey.
Thanks, Cap. But tell Frieda that
I'll tell her. Now, you just hurry along. Good luck, Jeffrey. Stay alive, boy.
Uh-huh.
down for the state. Take a rifle, you stupid. And keep it calm. Luke, that way 25 yards. Ben, stay right here, be still and listen. The rest of you, come on.
She's up.
Huh? Oh, she's up. Let me sleep, will you?
I'm going over there. Get some coffee. Come on, it'll wake you up.
What?
I don't know, he'd never dare to come back here anyways.
Hey!
You're up early. You're waiting for him, huh? Well, he won't be back. He's pinned up in the hills here somewhere so he'll never get out. We ought to get him by noon.
Get off this property.
How about some coffee?
You want coffee from me?
We want it quick, too. You'll get it for us. Ain't she something?
Get off this porch.
That ain't neighborly.
I'll give you 3 seconds. One, two.
Okay, no coffee.
And she's as mean as he is. She's good looking, though. Wonder what she'll do after we get him.
You never know. Look, I got an hour's sleep coming. I'm taking it now. You watch.
Hey, Link, did you see the kid, Bud?
Yeah, I saw him.
Yeah. You know, his face was mashed in. Just like that.
Just like that, you wouldn't believe it.
He's crazy, Link. I'd like to ram this old rifle right down his middle.
He's crazy, all right. Look, let me sleep, will you?
Your face, the way you look. It was just a rabbit.
Oh, you crazy guy.
What'd you think? It was Jeff coming up? If I'd had a picture.
What a crazy stunt.
He's blown in a million pieces. I bet he thought the atom bomb hit him. Here comes Marsh and them. Come to relieve him.
What was that shooting for? Crazy guy blew up a rabbit just for fun.
Don't try that again. This thing ain't a game. Where are you going, Leroy?
All right, we'll spring out and follow you in a minute.
That Nebro startles me sometimes. A real hunter, though. Track a man down like a tiger. Then he ain't after my heart.
You're in the way.
What are you doing here?
Going in the house, see Jeff's woman. Any objection? Billy here is going to look after things till Jeff gets back. Come on, Billy.
Look out, she don't take a shotgun to you.
Morning. Remember me, ma'am? Thanks. This your man's name, Billy Miles. Real full-blooded Indian. What do you know about that? Oh, Billy here is going to look after things, man. You know, chores and such like. He sleep in the barn. You just feed him now and then, that's all. Give you something to do.
I manage.
I know you do, and you're all right. Yes, indeed, being a woman can be a tough thing sometimes. Well, he's fine. I talked to him.
Talked to whom?
Oh, I don't mean to say he's just saying. He's absolutely fine. Of course, I know there's no sense in telling you not to worry. All women worry. But he'll make out okay.
Where is he? Why doesn't he?
He got away all right.
He wouldn't tell me that.
Safe and sound.
I just can't understand it. Jeff doesn't deny that he fought Bob and I as fair as any man can two against one, but he never did the things they said he did to that boy.
Of course not. Jeff just had accident like any man might.
No, I can't believe it. He couldn't. How's it going to end? I don't see any end to it.
Everything will end if you just hang on. You like to wait for him in town? Billy here look after things.
No, I want to stay here. He might come home.
That's a girl. And you feel much better here, too.
I won't feel anything.
Now you just leave everything to Billy and it'll be all right. I got to run along home. Now don't you go trying to pack that worry alone. You got friends. So is Jeff.
Let you and me look around outside, huh?
Nebro.
I let him get away.
Don't see how I could miss. Just don't see how. How could I miss?
Shut up. We got him now. Why don't you get back in the car? Notify everybody to close in on this area. The rest of you, come on.
Where's Al? I want to talk to Al.
He's not here. What are you
Where is
about?
He? Where?
He's not here.
Not Jeff. Here?
Jeff, he's not here. He's not here. No, don't you go out there. No. Al's out after you, Jeff. Here. Oh, look at you. Here, let me help you. Sit down. Sit. Look at you. You look awful. Let me give you a drink. Here, drink this. They didn't chase you here, did they? They're not close, are they?
I don't know. I lost them about 10 minutes ago. I want to talk to Al or Marsh. I got to make them understand it was an accident.
I know.
What do you mean, you know?
Why, nothing, Jeff. No, it's your chumpy. I guess you got a right to be with the whole pack of them out after you like that. When I heard that, I thought I'd go crazy. Oh, darling, I knew you'd come to me. I just knew it. Let's run away. I could put you in the back of the car. I could hide you there. They'd let me by.
We could go anywhere, Mexico, anywhere you say.
Go away with you?
Oh, Jeff, you don't understand. I love you.
Look, Gary, cut it out. I came here to talk to Al to try to make him listen to reason. I can't stay here. I gotta go home.
Well, you can't go home. They're watching your place.
Oh, I'll get there somehow. Once I'm home, I can do anything. Carrie, I'm sick of running.
No, no, no. You belong here. I won't let you go. Oh, look here, Jeff. You started this thing, and anything that happens is your fault. But, Jeff, listen. I can fix it. They'll listen to me.
You can fix it?
They'll believe anything I tell them. I'll tell them Al did it. I don't care. I'll tell them that Al did it because he knew that Bob was in love with me.
Bob in love with Worthy?
No, but they'll believe me. I'm the only one that can help you, Jeff. I got you into this. I'm going to get you out. I'm going to fix it.
What do you mean you got me into this?
Jeff. Good. No, no, no. The whole roof is with them. Get back into the bedroom. The bedroom.
Seating you.
I'm surprised you remember where you live.
I think my mom getting nagged at.
What did you come home for?
See you. Hey! What other man come home for?
You look disgusting. Go in the bedroom and change your shirt. It's filthy.
I don't know what for. I'm going out after him.
Go into the bedroom and change your shirt.
All right. Go and get me when I don't
get
you.
Get it yourself. All right.
Don't yell.
Let's pause a moment and turn again to our Westinghouse program. A clean dress every school day. Say, she must have a real hard-working mother.
Well, she has a real smart mother who looked at just dozens of washing machines and then chose the new 1953 Westinghouse laundromat for the two best reasons in the whole wide world. First, because the laundromat is so easy to use, and second, because it gets clothes so much cleaner. I'm going to tell you about that in a minute, but first, let me tell you about why it's so easy to use. Well, for one thing, this handy loading shelf is even bigger than before. And there's no stooping or crouching when you load the clothes in, as there is with many other washers. And of course, this weigh-to-save door actually weighs your clothes to save soap, hot water, and money. You read the weight on this scale right here. Then you set the water saver dial according to the weight. Then when you've loaded all the clothes into the laundromat, you add just the right amount of soap, start the laundromat, and that's all. Now let me tell you why the laundromat gets your clothes so much cleaner. It's because of the exclusive wash away, rinse away action that gets dirt out and keeps dirt out. Now, if you could look inside ordinary washers, here's what you'd see, a straight up and down tub like this. Now, when it's time for the dirty wash water to drain out, it drains right down through the clothes. The clothes settle to the bottom of the tub, and the water drains through, and the clothes act as a filter. The water leaves dirt and soap curds all through the clothes. Now, here is a diagram of the laundromat with its exclusive slant action. The clothes are washed in this position, and then when it's time for the water to drain out, the basket tilts back like that. The clothes are lifted up and away from the water while the dirty wash water drains away from the clothes. And there's no filtering back through the clothes. Your clothes are washed cleaner. Yes, you can easily see why the laundromat's wash-away action gets dirt out and its rinse-away action keeps dirt out. See it at your dealers. And you'll see why the new 1953 Westinghouse laundromat and the clothes dryer are America's favorite twins. Remember, you can be sure if it's Westinghouse.
the Westinghouse Studio One and The Kill.
You look at me like I was a bug. Like I feel great to come home.
What makes you think I care whether you come home or not?
Carrie, one day I'm gonna...
Get away from me.
I don't know how I keep myself from it.
You sent him in the bedroom after me. I heard you tell him why.
I was just giving you your chance.
Harry, you're crazy.
Stop. Stop. Stop.
What are you trying to do? You told me that you got me into it and you'd get me out. How can you get me out? How?
David, I saw Bob after you left. That'll clear your marshal. Believe anything I tell him. I'll say that I saw Al go back to Bob.
And how'll I go for that?
Listen, I'll go and get Al. We'll agree on a place and we'll meet there, but you'll be waiting out of sight. Why don't you see? They're hunting you down. It'll be self-defense.
You're insane.
Come on. March. Someone's leaving.
Obviously, getting in Marsh's car.
Jack, Marsh and Al are coming in. Quick, back into the bedroom. Quick! Marsh, what are you doing?
Came to tell your story, Carrie.
Huh?
A couple hours ago, a neighbor caught up with Jeff in the woods. Took a shot at him. Jeff got away. We combed the area fine. He ain't there. You know what I think, Carrie? I think you're hiding, Jeff. That plain enough?
I told him I looked. Yeah, he ain't here, Marsh.
You're crazy, Marsh.
Maybe.
No, he ain't there. I looked.
No!
There he is! We'll get him! Get him!
I think we'll have to wait. And you've grown up some more.
No! I can do it now, please.
Philip, keep handling.
My daddy! You look all whiskey. Give me a hug.
Billy, wait. We'll make up watching the place. Link and Jane. Listen. I'm going inside. Take Carol around there. Keep him busy until I get in, will you? Jeff, use your hand. They can cut you down. Do what I say, will you? Go on.
Okay, it's your party. Come on, Carol. Let's go for a ride.
My daddy's coming home. My daddy's coming home. My daddy's coming home.
What'd she say? Where's your daddy, honey?
I saw him. I saw him.
Where?
At the station.
It's just a game. Kids, make up games.
Yeah. Come on, let's take a look.
All right, drop it. Go.
Dave!
Jeff! Oh. Take it easy, baby. Easy.
Are you all right?
Yeah, honey, I'm all right.
Oh, what have they done to you? You look so... Well, now first food and then you'll sleep.
I can't eat, honey. Listen, how was it here? The day...
That came with me. It was years I died every minute.
Yeah, me too. Listen, honey. I went up to Carrie's house. She hid me.
I love you, Jeff.
Darling, I know now that I didn't kill Bubba. I don't know who did, but I wish they'd come and get me and get it over with.
Jeff, what's going to happen to us?
I don't know.
And if we ever get out of this, we'll never come back here again, ever.
Leave here you can.
Can't I? All my friends and neighbors hunt me down like I was a mad dog. I don't know whether I did it or not, but they don't care. I just can't stand the sight of them anymore.
Oh, Jeff, this is your home. You're a part of this life here.
Not anymore, I'm not. Not since that first bullet went by me. But I don't want to talk about it now. I want to get some sleep.
Let me get your breath. Let me handle it.
Look, you sure you can?
I think so. Don't worry, darling, if I make one move.
Listen, baby. Marsh and the others will be here in a little while. When they come, I want you to call me. We'll face it out with them, face to face. We're not going to be afraid anymore.
Clean. Oh, if he got Clary head for home, that's the only place for him to go now. Unless he doubled back here and she's hiding him again.
Look. Look. You stay out here. You cover me, huh?
He's in there. I'll take care of him.
And I'll handle her, too.
She sent me into the bedroom there. She sent me in there knowing he was in there with a gun.
Carrie, what got into you? Your own husband.
He was half crazy. He broke in here with a gun. I thought he was going to kill me.
You're lying. Tell it again straight.
All right, I hit him.
Why?
Shut up!
Why, Carrie?
Because suppose you caught Jeff. Suppose you shot him. Then you'd be in a lot of trouble, wouldn't you?
We could take a lot of that kind of trouble.
Why don't you give it up? Why don't you quit, honey?
Give it up?
If you know what you're doing, I mean.
Why are you so anxious to protect Jeff?
Why are you so anxious to put a bullet in him? Is it something you're trying to keep Jeff from saying? Or are you afraid that somebody might ask you about your brother,
Bob? Shut up. What's she driving at? You meant something, I'll say it out.
Well, you can't pay. That's what she says.
You've been keeping something back, both of you. Now you're going to talk. You've been hitting. Now spill it.
All right, you want me to talk, I'll talk.
Now you shut your mouth. You can't believe what she says. I don't know what she did. Hiding Jeff?
Sure, I hid Jeff. You know what it means to love a man for 12 years and live with something like this? Do you think I want you to kill Jeff just to save your own neck? Sure, I love Jeff. But Al thought I was in love with your brother Bob, that he was in love with me.
You shut up. You shut up.
Now, who do you think the murderer is? Answer me, Marsh. Who do you think went back after the fight at the irrigation pump and found Bob hurt and bashed his head in with a shovel?
Jeff out here, we come to take him and we're gonna get him.
Come on, what's the matter, you guy? You let this woman hold you back?
Get out of my way.
Get back!
We have to shoot you too.
Go ahead, I expect you. Look, if you're hunting him in a gang, why don't you come after him one at a time?
You don't go after a crazy man one at a time. Come on, let's finish him now. What's holding you guys back?
I'll tell you, they're thinking maybe that you're screaming after Jeff's blood for nothing. They're thinking maybe he didn't do it.
You
know he...
Don't let her speak.
Who said that, Nebro? You're Jeff's friend. Who shot, fired the first shot, Nebro? And Dave Waters, good old Dave Waters, Jeff's boyhood pal. Did you ever ask Jeff if he killed Bob? And the rest of you, you're just a pack of howling wolves. The
resemblance to human beings.
All right, here I'm going to be. Link, Dave, Nebro, come on now. We're all face to face.
Jeff, there's a couple of things I'd like to talk over with you.
Is there? Hello, Al.
The kid and Jeff. Come to kill you. Not with them, just me.
All right, why don't you start shooting? What are you so nervous about? Where's Marsh?
Marsh is dead.
Dead?
Get away. Marsh is dead and so is Carrie.
Carrie?
Now, I'm going to blow a hole for you, Jeff.
Wait a minute, Al. Marsh went out hunting for Jeff after he left your place.
Jeff's been here ever since.
Yeah, but you weren't where you are. You were back there with Marsh and Carrie.
How about it, Al?
Sure. Carrie wanted to tell me something. She was trying to tell me something. I'll bet she told Marsh. You killed him, Al.
Yeah, that's what I've been wondering.
I'll be on my way, Link. So help me out.
Al, listen.
Jeff, hurry up.
Hold on, Jeff.
Say, I guess. I'm sorry, Jeff.
You'll listen. I'm ashamed. I ain't never done nothing like this before in my life.
Yeah, Jeff. It was sort of like a sickness, like. I know it ain't much, but I'll be sorry about this till the day I die.
Sure. A few kind words and everything's gonna be forgotten, huh? Well, get out of here, all of you. Get out right now, and I'll be doing the same with pleasure.
My name's Delsman. I'm the sheriff of Springville. What are all you people doing up here? I heard some rumors about a manhunt. Who's this? What happened to him? Dead. Shot. All right, who shot him? Come on, one of you shot him. Who was it? One of you two? Come on, speak up. Who killed this man?
You all struck dumb.
Who killed him? Come on.
You feel like opening your mouth?
All right. I killed him. That suits you? I'm taking you in.
Let him go, Telson.
He's coming with me. Now, wait a minute. Get back. Get back. You can't.
Of course, get in your car and drive it home.
You don't know what you're doing. Get back! Get back!
You heard what he said before you get hurt.
All right. But I'm coming back. If it takes an army, I'll get him. You people don't make the laws.
Wait a minute, Nelson.
I'll go with you and straighten this thing out.
You got nothing to worry about, Jeff.
We're all witnesses, Jeff.
Right. I'll tell him just the way it was.
We'll back you up, Jeff. And then if you need a hand to get started here, when you come home...
Jeff. We'll... Don't let this thing drive you out. Men average up. I guess we're better than some, maybe worse than others. And we'll be a long time squaring ourselves.
Jeff.
I don't know, honey. Seems like we're welcome us home. Everybody's so willing to forgive and forget. I don't expect you to forget ever. But I know these people and I understand them. And give them a little time and well, maybe we ought to stick it out. What do you say?
Welcome home, darling.
Betty Furness wants you to meet a beautiful writer.
Here she is. Her name is Sigrid Olson, and she's the most beautiful writer in her class since she got her new Everlast ballpoint pen. Let's see what she's written. Writes like a dollar pen, only 25 cents. Well, that sounds like a real bargain, doesn't it? And it is amazing. This pen has a precision ball-bearing nib. It has a long-lasting ink supply, and it refills by cartridge, and that cap looks just like real gold. Now, let me tell you all you have to do to get it. Just get any three-pack carton of Westinghouse light bulbs, just like this. Now, you're going to be needing them anyway. Westinghouse bulbs are brighter burning, longer lasting. You can get them at your hardware or variety store, at your grocer's, druggist, stationer's, department store, anywhere where Westinghouse bulbs are sold. Then just take the wrapper off the carton and send one wrapper and 25 cents with your name and address for each pen that you want. Mail them to Westinghouse, Box 883, Brooklyn, New York. You better write that down, Box 883, Brooklyn, New York. Now, the supply of these pens is limited, so you better send for yours right away. Tomorrow, get your carton of Westinghouse bulbs and send the wrapper and 25 cents and get your beautiful Everlast ballpoint pen.
Pick the winner. Election day is almost here. Westinghouse brings you Pick the Winner every Sunday afternoon on CBS Radio, Thursday nights on CBS TV. See and hear the nation's political experts debate the most important issues in the coming election on Westinghouse Pick the Winner.
Absorbing City Hospital on the CBS television network.